Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing one more example of Cauchy integral theorem. We have till now discussed four examples. This will be our fifth example. So friends, welcome back. In the four examples that we have discussed, in all the examples we took circle. Now for the very first time we'll be taking ellipse. Now let us see how to solve the problem based on ellipse. So this is the given equation. First of all, you might be wondering, is this ellipse or circle? So let me tell you, the equation of circle is x square plus y square is equal to, let's say, r square, where r is the radius. So we should have one here and one here. In this case, besides x square we have one, but besides y square we don't have one actually. So therefore this is not a circle. So this should be very clear to you. Now the equation is actually ellipse. So let me tell you what exactly the equation of ellipse is. X square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. You might be thinking, this equation is not like ellipse, right? But we can convert it into ellipse. How we can do that? See here, if you divide this equation by 4, let me divide it and let me check what happens. So if you divide by 4, this is x square upon 4 plus y square upon 1 is equal to 1. Now friends, see, this equation is exactly converted in the form of ellipse. Now let me tell you this equation, how the ellipse will look like. This is your x axis and this is your y axis. This is your ellipse. This particular distance is, see, if it is a square, the distance will be a comma 0. And on y axis, if we have b square here, then this distance will be 0 comma b. Now in our example, the equation is x square upon 4 plus y square upon 1 is equal to 1. That means this particular distance should be square root of this, that is 2, 0, and this particular distance on y axis is square root of this. So 1 square root is 1 only, so this is 0, 1. So this is 2 and this is 1. So this is the given region for this particular case. Now let us start solving the problem and check which point is lying inside and which point is lying outside. Problem is 4z minus 1 upon z square minus 3z minus 4 dz. First of all, we need to identify the poles. For that purpose, we need to equate denominator to 0. So the poles are z square minus 3z minus 4 equal to 0. That is z minus 4. Z plus 1 equal to 0, Z is equal to 4, and Z is equal to minus 1. Two poles we got, one is 4, another one is minus 1. Now let us check which is inside, which is outside. Z is equal to 4. As discussed, Z is x plus iy. So only real part is given, 4. So real part value is actually x value. So this indicates 4, 0. Because 4 means 4 plus 0i, so imaginary part value is 0. And here it is, again only minus 1 is given. Minus 1 means minus 1 plus 0i. So x value is minus 1 and y value is 0. So let us plot these two points. 4, 0 will be somewhere around here. So you can easily see this point is outside ellipse and minus 1, 0. Since this point is minus 2, 0, minus 1, 0 will lie inside the ellipse. So it's a clear problem of one point inside, one point outside. So what we're going to do? Yes, the point which is lying outside will go up. So 4z minus 1, actually we have z minus 4 and z plus 1 dz, these two points, in which z minus 4 is outside, so that will go up. what is the next step? You're going to treat numerator as phi of z. So your phi of z is 4z minus 1 upon z minus 4. Here the problem is of simple pole lying inside, that is minus 1. So phi of minus 1 is equal to minus 1, here I am going to put here. So minus 1 into 4 is minus 4 minus phi upon minus phi again. So that is 1. The final answer is by CIT, integration C, 4z minus 1 upon z square minus 3z minus 4 dz is equal to 2 pi I into phi of z0. So 2 pi I into phi of z0, which is 1. So the answer is 2 pi I. So friends, we are done with Cauchy integral theorem. In the next videos, we'll be discussing the last and the final part of complex integration, that is residues. Thank you.